Zave bites no de ode, im ne ode, jef, hui se no de, jes eit kanapsos us haskata.
Good afternoon. It's so good to be here with you today to share God's word, to share this message, and start off the new year praising the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Yes, it's the new year, a new time. You know, it's always fascinating to me how people get ready for the new year. They plan and they get excited about it. And then deep in their minds, they know that it's a new beginning. So they think about resolution. I'll wait until the new year and then I'm going to start on some good things in my life. Maybe dropping old habits. Well, if you think about it, it's just a day, right? It's just a normal day like any other. But because on the calendar, it's the beginning of the year, It's just a good time to start things new. You could do this anytime. You could do it at the beginning of the week. In fact, that's why we have Badarak on the beginning of the week, because you take the body and blood of Jesus Christ inside of you and you have an opportunity to start the week brand new, putting aside the old self and starting in a new life. Well, the new year gives us that opportunity too, right? We have 365 days, and this year we get an extra day too, don't we? We have 366 days to really tone ourselves up. And so the beginning of the year is a time for us to reflect on the past and to start brand new, putting aside old habits. And we call this New Year's resolutions. We resolve to do something better. Now, this can be very easy for many things that you have in your life. Like you may resolve to, you know, like I decided instead of waking up at 7:30, I'm going to wake up at 7:15. And then you say, well, that's kind of easy. Or it could be very difficult. Some of the habits that have been worn away. One of the most famous habits that everybody always tries at New Year's is giving up smoking, for instance, because it's so addictive and it's usually a good time to say, we'll try it. Okay, we'll try giving up smoking. Giving up some of the bad habits, like for instance eating or drinking. Well, you don't give up everything, okay, because you do need some food, but maybe the excesses, right? The excesses in life. It's just a good time to start brand new. Now, you can have all kinds of success or you can have all kinds of failure. But the person who approaches it with faith, approaches their new beginnings with faith, has an extra added dimension to their lives. In other words, has some extra power. I'm going to read to you from the book of Revelations. Actually, it comes from chapter 21, verse 5. Just listen to this. It's just one sentence because Jesus has gone through saying that he will wipe away every tear and everything. And he says, behold, I make all things new. Let's say that again. Behold, I make all things new. Who makes all things new? Christ makes all things new. The person who lives with Christ has an opportunity to start brand new every single day. Of course, if you want to use the new year, that's a great opportunity. And that's why I'm talking about it today. It's just a perfect opportunity to start things brand new. You say, Christ says, I make all things new. Now, Christ is the one person that can't lie. You see, we have friends, we have relatives, people, not that they want to lie, but will make mistakes. God can't make a mistake. Christ is perfect. And so when he says something, it's absolutely true. Behold, I make all things new. Do you want a new life? Do you want something new in your life? Do you want to put away some of the old habits? This is a perfect time to start. And the exciting part of the Christian's journey is that it is not a one-day event. It is not something that takes place on January 1st and then you forget about it on January 2nd. It's something that is constantly being renewed. What did I say a few minutes ago? We go to the Divine Liturgy, the Badarak, every Sunday morning. Why is that? Because by taking Christ in, what happens? Behold, I make all things new. You have an opportunity to start new. And the Christian's greatest strength is to be able to put things in perspective, putting things in the back and moving forward. I think it's beautiful that God has created us with a face the way it is. Yeah, not just the way we all look, but think about how our faces are. We've got eyes on the front of our face. Behind our heads, we have no eyes. Don't you think that's beautiful? Because as human beings, we can only face forward. You can't look back. Now, of course, I'm using the metaphor, but you understand very well. In life, you can't look backwards. If you look back, you can't go forwards. And this is the beautiful thing about the Christian life. It's an opportunity to put the old self to sleep. Let it die. Let it be forgotten. As a Christian, we come up to the idea of repentance, the idea of forgiveness of sins. We forgive our sins, and once they are forgiven, they're done. It's over. You could put a nail in that coffin. It's done. Now the only thing that is required of us is to move forward. Now in that moving forward, you may have to reconcile a lot of things that your sin has done. For instance, if you've been angry with somebody, it's just not enough to say, okay, well, I know God forgives me. You need to be able to go and reconcile with those people. Some of the habits that we want to overcome in the new year may be easy or difficult. Some of the habits that I'm going to suggest to you are the ones that Christ suggests. If you notice in the scriptures, Christ doesn't talk about giving up smoking. He doesn't talk about giving up drinking. What he does talk about is giving up anger, giving up hatred, reconciling with one another. The true Christian is called to a life of being able to be reconciled with brother, with sister, with parents, with children. We go through life and we pick up a lot of baggage, don't we? We pick up a lot of problems in our lives. You need to be able to reconcile. In other words, put those baggages down. Remember what our Lord tells us. He says, if you go to church to take your offering and you remember you have a grievance against your brother, leave your offering at the altar and go and make up with your brother. What's Christ telling us? There is something more important than God. Yes, I'm a priest of the church and I'm telling you that. There is something more important than God. You know why I'm telling you that? Because Christ tells us that. He says, leave your offering there. It's no good. Leave your offering, leave God right there, and go and reconcile. Go and become friends. Go and say, I'm sorry to your neighbors. And then come to God. It means nothing to say, I praise God, I love God, but still have that anger, that jealousy, that envy in your heart. You need to be able to reconcile with one another. Christ talks about the newness in one of his parables. He says, nobody takes old wineskins and puts new wine into it. Wineskins, of course, that we don't use too many of those. Now we have bottles. When you go and purchase some wine, you buy it in bottles. In the olden times, there used to be skins, and they would put the wine in there. And, you know, wine is a little bit acidy, and so it eats away at those skins. Basically, those skins end up broken and end up opening up. So the old wineskins have to be thrown away. And Christ says, you can't take new wine and put it in the old wineskin. What he's telling you is that the new wine needs to go into the new wineskin. At this new year, you have an opportunity to be that receptacle where the newness of Christ comes into you. Behold, I make all things new, he says. He can't lie. He wants to make you new. He wants to make me new. He wants to make this world new. He wants to make this world a world of peace, a world of harmony, and a world of love. How do you do that? Well, by making each individual a complete individual, one that is reconciled with himself and with his neighbors. And you have that opportunity today. Actually, you have that opportunity all the time. But because on the calendar it says that this is a new year, it's just a good opportunity. And the Christian looks for those opportunities. I want you to find that in your life. Whatever difficulties you have, sometimes those habits that we talk about, the New Year's resolutions, are the easy ones. Don't eat, don't drink, don't smoke, things like that. I want you to take the Jesus challenge. How about reconciling, loving one another? I promise that this year I will love more than I did last year. I promise this year I will not anger as quickly as I did last year. I promise this year that I will use it as an opportunity every single day to radiate God's love through my life. Those are resolutions too. And you may not reach it. You may get angry one day. You may get angry every single day. That doesn't mean you've lost. It just means you are human. You're not God. And so give yourself a break this year. Give yourself an opportunity to move forward. Move forward in the scriptures, move forward in faith, and become all that you are meant to be, all that God wants you to be. This is the message that comes to us on this new year as we get ready for the big theophany coming up this week. Now, you know that we were in a period of Advent, and of course, this period of Advent ends with the celebration of theophany. This is the final message that we have on this Sunday as it gets us closer, the message of newness, the message of new beginnings. And so, when we arrive at the theophany, when we say Christ has been revealed among us, Christos imechmet haidnetzav, zanaviv haidnetzav. This is truly the great message that comes into the heart of the Christian, not by way of just words, but by way of actions and reality in his or her life. Accept that message. It's coming to us very beautifully and very quickly. Hey, I want to give you this chance to get involved wherever you may be. Get involved in one of your churches. If you don't have a church, please go down to the diocesan website. Find a church that's close to you. Just pull down that parish's level. Call them up. Send them an email and tell them, hey, I want to get involved. Get involved with your priest, with the people within the community. If you want to get involved with me, I'm at epostle.net. That's Apostolic Evangelism for an Electronic and Expanding Universe. So until next week, Happy New Year. I look forward to seeing you. And we will always glorify the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.